Breaking news: freed Niger State commissioner says his kidnap was a setup that even left the gunmen in tears. Hello, my wonderful people. We've been saying it that the kidnapping and many more things that are going on in this country, there are people who knows about it, orchestrating it and allowing it to happen. Now, Niger State Commissioner for Information that was kidnapped, and we brought you up to speed on that, is revealing what really happened. You will be shocked. You will be shocked. He said his kidnapped was a setup. So you think things that are happening in this country are just happening like that? There are people who are aiding, supporting, and enhancing it to happen. Other than that, some of these things would not happen in any way possible. But sadly, they are happening because some persons, you know, have taken it upon themselves to make Nigeria a place that is not inhabitable for all. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if this is your first time. Let's get the details. What really happened? Freed Niger State Commissioner says his kidnap was a setup that left even the gunmen in tears. His family says no ransom was paid. The Niger State Commissioner for Information, Mohammed Idris, said his adoption by gunmen on the 9th of Saturday, August the 8th, 2021, was a setup. Idris was freed at about 9:30 p.m. on Thursday. His kidnappers dropped him at a spot outside Suleja town. Speaking to members of his community in Baba Tongo town, Tafe local government area of Niger State, Idris said his adopters told him he was receiving 200 million from Governor Abubakar Sani Bello every month. Are you listening? Are you listening, guys? I'll take that again. Speaking to the members of his community in Baba Tongo town, Tafe local government area of Niger State, Idris, that's the commissioner for information, says his adopters told him he's receiving monthly 200 million from Governor Abubakar Sani Bello every month. He added that those who set him up paid the gunmen and also gave them a picture of his house in the village and how to get him adopted. The gunmen insist that they must get nothing less than 200 million out of the money, which is the same amount of money they are being given by the governor. The commissioner tells the small crowd of sympathizers what he experienced during his captivity. He says the kidnappers would later realize that the information they got was wrong. I left them crying. They have been regretting their actions. I have forgiven those who set me up and the kidnappers, he said. On how he regained his freedom, Idris said, it is the work of God. The kidnappers don't know this community. I have forgiven them. Here and thereafter, members of his family says no ransom was paid. The Niger State government is yet to issue a statement on his release. There has been an escalation of kidnapping for ransom in Nigeria's northern region in the last couple of years. My dear, what do you have to say? This is the governor saying that his kidnappers have been receiving 200 million every month from a governor. You don't understand what is happening. You don't understand it. Have you thought about it? All the weapons and all the things that are flying by, they are not passing the air now. They are passing the land. They are going through land. Should I tell you what? There are people aiding, supporting what is going on in this country. Don't you think these things are just happening? You will be deceiving yourself. There are people who are responsible. When you look at it, my dear, we always say to you that things do not just happen. There are people who are orchestrating these things. Maybe he said there is a particular governor, you heard it, who is giving them 200 million. And he said for them to release him, he's not going to give them less than what the governor is giving them monthly. Do you know what is 200 million? There are people who do not have jobs. Eh? That money, if the government channels it very well, he will employ more people. But what is it causing? More insecurity. You see devils that we have. And you see them walking past with their agbada and behaving, and they'll be giving talk. Yeah, the insecurity. That's why in the north, listen, guys, they cannot do anything to Fulani herdsmen, Boko Haram or terrorists. No, they can't do anything to them. Why would you want to do something to them? They are your foot soldiers. So you have to ensure, look for a way to say either they are repentant bandits or they've changed. You have to look for a way. You can't do anything to them. You can't. Why would you want to do something to the very people you are using? They will expose you. He said the people were crying. They gave them his home because they didn't know. So they gave them the picture. They directed them to him. You see? And guess what? The governor of the state has not answered up till now. We've not heard a single word in that reply to say what he said was true or was lie and all that. And they come out, they come to say, these people have taken over. It's all a plan. And I don't know what they are really after. That they make the place very ungovernable. They make the place very terrible. People cannot go to their businesses. Children that were captured in Niger State, they were going to this Islamic school. Children, I'm talking about age 3, 4, 5, 6. Children that young. I don't know what they want to use them for. Yes, I don't know. You know they've not been released. Oh, you're not aware. They've still not been released. Not knowing that the governor is giving some people 200 million every month. And they tell you there's no money. And there's no money. Things are this, that. They'll be telling you one thing or the other. My dear, these people are devils. These people are devils. Devils, I tell you. Devils. 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 Eh? My people, leave us a comment. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if this is your first time. Let's get so that we can get going. You need to know what's going on. This is terrible. This is what happens. God will help us. Bye for now.